Namaste to aspirants of Ayurveda. I am Dr. Mangaladhari Rao, working as Associate Professor in the Department of Swasthavritta and Yoga, Faculty of Ayurveda, Institute of Medical Sciences, Banaras Hindu University. Today, we will be discussing on a very important aspect, that is Janapadodvamsa. Again, in this lecture, I will be covering only the classical Ayurvedic aspects. What are the different areas where this Janapadodvamsa has been covered, and what are the different reasons that have been quoted classically? Along with that, certain remedies that can be implemented so that the Janapadodvamsa can be prevented. All these cover only the classical aspect and the principles, not really some management specific to certain diseases. As the word itself tells, Janapada means a large community. Uth is upasarga and dvamsa is destruction. Here in Janapadodvamsa, a large community is destroyed simultaneously due to some common factor that is existing in the surrounding of that particular community. And this particular aspect is covered in Charaka Samhita under Vimanasthana, in Sushruta Samhita, Sutrasthana, Ashtanga Hridaya Sutrasthana, as well as Ashtanga Sangraha in Sutrasthana. What is the etiological factor for Janapadodvamsa? It has been mentioned, Dvivido Hetur Vyadi Janakaha Prani Nam Bhavati Sadharanaha Asadharanascha Tatra Sadharanam Prati Purusha Niyatam Vatadi Janaka Maharad Yabhidaya Bahujana Sadharanam Vata Jala Desha Kala Rupam Sadharana Roga Karanam Abhidhatum Janapadodvamsa Niyam Abhidhiyate. So, two main factors, that is Sadharana and Asadharana. Sadharana is common to all the people who are residing nearby, and it may be in the form of the vata or the surrounding air, jala or the water, desha or the region, and kala or the season. Further, what are the basic reason for this Janapadodvamsa? Vaivadinam yavad vaigunyam utpadyate tasya moolam adharmaha tan moolam va asatkarmaha purvakritam ta tayor yonihi prajnaparadha eva. So, the basic cause is adharma, or not following the rules and regulations as mentioned in our classics, and asatkarma, or indulging into unruly behavior or wrongful behavior. Why? Due to prajnaparadha, that is the intellectual errors. We know that a particular thing is going to be harmful for a particular problem, still we are indulging into that kind of activity, that is prajnaparadha. Yada vai desha nagara nigama janapada pradhana. So, where exactly these asatkarma? Desha, in the entire region, nagara, or a particular city, or a particular part of city, or a particular community in a city. So, all these people indulge into the behavior. Dharmam utkramya dharmena prajam vartayante. So, dharmam utkramya, they are not following the rules. Dharma here doesn't mean the religion, but certain rules and regulations that are to be followed for the health of the individual as or the community, that are not followed by praja or the one who are residing in a particular region. Then, tata antarhita adharmano devata abhirapi tyajyante. Because of that reason, the devatas are not following the dharma or the rules. Like, as per rules, like certain of the factors, that is vata is maintained by the Vayudeva, or like that, maybe it is, you feel a bit of mythological thing, but still when we are not following the rules and regulations, then the environment itself causes hazards in the form of the different kinds of the manifestations in the surrounding environment. And yatha kalam devo varshati na varshati vikritam va varshati. So if the rain occurs, either it is untimely rain or even the rain with the vikriti or the vitiation. For example, if we are indulging in the unruly behavior in the form of different forms of the pollutants, usage of the pollution, we are causing environment pollution, then there is this leads to the variations in the seasons. We observe different problems due to the environmental pollution in the present day, whether in the form of global warming or in the form of acid rains or in the very heavy pollution that is leading to many respiratory tract diseases. So all these things we are observing today. So the same thing has been told: we are not following the rule, then the environment is getting affected. In the ancient times, they used to use the name of God only to create a kind of fear so that the person is not going to indulge into a wrongful behavior. And kshatir vyapadayate, that is, it is going to cause the kshati or the harm or destruction in different form. And oshadayah swabhavam parihayapadayanti vikritim. Even the plants that are grown, medicines that are grown, that get vitiated. This can be observed. The land pollution leads to the problem or different manifestations that are getting in the plants. Here we can see biomagnification of the different pollutants that we are discarding into the land, or we are using different kinds of the fertilizers or pesticides into the agriculture system or in any plant-based ecology, that will be going to cause the problem in the plant itself. And we can see many of the especially the rhizomes, they are having high level of the heavy metals only because we are polluting the land. So this gets manifested in the vitiation. And udbhavsante janapadaha sprishya vyavaharya doshat. So this we can observe certain places wherein we are using many of the pesticides, or some factories, they are leaving the unpolluted water or untreated water into the water bodies. Their incidence of cancers are more because the water is polluted, even the land gets polluted. So this particular unruly behavior we can observe in present day life also. Then there is another factor for the Janapadodhvamsa, that is asadharana, that is nakshatra graha gana chandra surya anila analanam disham cha aprakriti bhutanam ritu vaikarika bhavaha. That is the impact of the abnormality in the stars, planets, or the chandra surya anila, that is moon, sun, and the air around, as well as the fearful thing like anala or the fire factor, that are getting vitiated and leading to ritu vaikarika, that is the variation in the seasons. And due to that, bhumer virasi bhavat udvamsah, that is the normal features of the land that is going to impact it, and that will again cause the dvamsa or the destruction. Again, rasa virya vipaka prabhavan upalakshyam ahe. That is, the when land is impacted, at that time, whatever the plants are grown, their rasa, virya, vipaka, etc., they get modified, and we are not going to get the best medicine or even the ahara dravyas. Rutu vaikarika cha upalakshanam tena jala desha vata vikaraya bhuta iti mantavya. So when there is rutu vikriti or vishesha of the season, then the other factors like the water or the land and the air, all are going to get vitiated, and rutvana anurupa rutu vaikarikaha. That is when the seasons are not having the normal features that have to be usually present, they are called as rutu vaikarika. And this is mainly due to the impact of the nakshatra and the even the impact of the vitiation of the movement of the planets around. Further, due to that, the bheshaja sadhya rogaste asamoshadhinam rasadinam upal anupayokshyanti ityartah. That is, whenever the diseases they are getting manifested due to this janapadodhvamsakara bhavas, then such diseases which can be treated should be treated with the proper medication as per the general principles that are mentioned in Ayurveda. Now let us discuss about the different janapadodhvamsakara bhavas. Titu khalvime bhavaha samanya janapadeshu bhavanti tadyatha vayuhu udakam desham kala iti. So four factors are considered among the janapadodhvamsakara bhavas, that is vayu, udaka, desha and kala. Again, discussing about each features of the vitiation. Vitiation of the vata. Tatra vatam evam vidham anarogyakaram vidyat. The vitiated vata will be leading to different kinds of the disorders, and how that features of the vayu. Tatra rutu vishamam, which is not as per the characters mentioned for the different rutus. Atisthimitam, which is devoid of any movement. Atichalitam, with very fierce movement. And atiparusham, which is very dry. Atishitam, which is very cold. Atiushnam, which is very hot. And atiruksham, which is very dry. And atiabhishyandi, which is very humid. Atibhairava, which is very fierce with different kinds of the motions. And apratihatam paraspara gati kundalinam, that is the different kinds of the winds with a very fierce movement, circular rotatory movements, which we can relate to the tsunami kinds of the things. And asatmya gandha, that which is having a different kinds of the odor. And bhashpa, again lot of humidity is there. And sikata, which is having the sand particles. And pamshu, again gravels. And dhumopahatam, which is smoky. So these kinds of the wind, it is vikrita or vitiated. These things emphasize one thing, is the natural calamity which can be related to different kinds of the cyclones that occur. Again, they come under the vitiated vata. Again, we nowadays see lot of cyclones due to the environmental effects, due to global warming. And again, along with that, certain things manifested like asatmya gandha and all, we can see that is due to the highly polluted air. Especially nowadays, especially in India, in the winter seasons, in the northern India, due to the very cold wind and very much enhanced pollution level, the air also, if we breathe in, a very odd smell will be there, or sometimes it is pungent, and it will cause burning sensation in the eyes, or allergic disorders or respiratory disorders. Such kinds of the problems are there. Or else some other manifestations like the smog, again in during the winter time, because of the high level of the pollutants, the smog is created, which will be causing haziness in the environment. Along with that, many of the respiratory tract disorders. Further, the features of Vikruta Jala. Udakam tu khalu atyartha Vikruta Gandha Varna Rasa Sparsha Kleda Bahula Apakranta Jalachara Vihangam Upakshinam Jalashaya Pritikara Apritikaram Gata Gunam Vidyat. Here, due to the vitiation of the water, the features of the water get more changed, and the water will be smelly or having a very bad odor, and again there are changes in the color as well as taste and the touch. Again it is slimy, or sometimes the water animals are there, they are dying. That can be observed. Many a times we see in this ocean so many of the fishes, they die. We can see nowadays in the TV channels wherein the many of the water animals, they are dying. And also Vihangam Upakshinam, one of the birds which drink that water, they get tired and they fall down. Such kinds of the features are manifested in the water that is vitiated. And also Vikrita Desha. Again, Vikrita Desha has many features. Desham Punaha Prakriti Vikrita Varna Gandha Rasa Sparsha. So here the again changes will be there with respect to the color, smell, taste as well as touch. Kleda Bahulam, lot of water is there, and Upasrishtam Sarisrupa Vyala Mashaka Shalabha Makshika Mushaka. So different kinds of the animals which where more of the reptiles are present, or very wild animals, or in different kinds of the insects, and even the rodents, or birds like Uluka, that is the owls, and Shmashanika Shakuna, like certain animals that are residing in the Smashana where more people are not inhabiting, and also the animals like Jambuka, that is the animals like bear, they are present there, or else Trina Ulupa Upavanantam, that is where a lot of large grass are grown. Pratanadi Bahulam, again where a lot of this roots of plants are available, such, or else Shushka Nashta Shasyam, wherein the grass has dried totally and there are no plants at all, and Dhumra Pavanam, the land wherein the smoky wind is there, and different animals like the Shrigala or Shvagana, the lot of animals that are going to cause different kinds of the disorders, or they can bite, such kinds of the place, it has to be there, the person should not reside. Then Vikrita Kala, Kalam tu Khalu Yathartu Linga Viparita Lingam Ati Lingam Hina Lingam Chahitam Vyavasyet. That is Kala, here season. It is like as per the seasons, different features have been described. Again, it should not be like Viparita Linga, that is opposite, or Hina Linga, that is if the rain is there, rainy season, if there is very less rain is present, then it is Hinalinga, and Atilinga, if that is excess of rain is there, then Atilinga. All these considered among the vitiation. Iman, Evan, Dosha, Yuktan, Chaturo, all the four types of the doshas or the vitiations, Bhavan, Janapadodvamsa, Karan, Vadanti, Kushalaha. So, all these four varieties of the vitiation that will be leading to destruction of the large community. Viguneshvapi khalu eteshu janapadodhvamsa kareshu bhaveshu bheshajena upapadyamanan abhayam bhavati rogebhya iti. So in all these conditions, the intake of the medicine again can be preventing the different kinds of the disorders. Again, the management of the vitiation of these four factors, that is vata, jala, desha, kala, all these four factors, that is difficult to manage. That is vata, jalam, jala, desham, deshat, kalam, svabhavatah, vidya, dushparihariyatva, gariyastasaram, arthavit. So, the vata is the most easiest one to manage, then more difficult is jala, from jala desha is more difficult and kala is the most difficult most, because here if kala is vitiated, then it is going to impact all the three, that is vata, jala and desha. These three factors are going to be impacted, and again among the asadharana factors, that is graha, nakshatra, gana moment, the kala is going to be impacted. So those factors we cannot intervene very easily. So that is the most difficult factor for intervention. And how exactly the vata can be counteracted by nivata desha sevaya, that is we can go to the place wherein the air is not much polluted, and then another way is deha vrityartham avashyam sevyam. So the jala, we are using it for the deha vritti or maintenance of our body, and jala pekshaya dushparihario bhavati tad vyatriktena deshantara gamanena tyajet. So if the land is polluted, then we should shift to the some other place. And again, in the present day context, if we think about, if the layer of soil is polluted, then it takes around more than 60 years to form a new layer of soil in general. So that much difficult. If air is polluted, it can naturally get purified by the perflation or movement of the wind, as well as due to the impact of the rain. If it rains, then again air get purified, or else by the sunlight also air gets purified. But for the land, it is not that easy. Framing a new layer of soil takes a lot of time. So only during that period they might have suggested for deshantara gamana. But in the present scenario, again it is quite difficult because inhabitable land is very less. So we have to be very careful whenever we are disposing different kinds of the waste. That adharma, what I was speaking about previously, so that has to be always avoided. We have to follow the rules and regulations as mentioned by the present government or present whatever the organizational body that is managing all these factors. And kalastu sarvata tyaktum ashakyam. So if kala is impacted, if season gets impacted, we cannot go anywhere. Anywhere we are residing, that influence of season we cannot escape from. So only they are considered difficult to manage stage by stage. Thank you for hearing this lecture. Thank you again.